He's a demon on wheels. He's a demon and he's gonna be chasing after someone. He's gaining on you, so you better look alive. He's busy revving up the powerful Mach5. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Saturday morning. I thought I would start off with a little Saturday morning cartoon action and show you guys another one of the Mach5 Speed Racer builds. One of my favorite cartoons as a kid growing up. I still like that cartoon. It's just a little more funnier now that I'm older. And yeah, you can catch on to a lot of the details in that cartoon. Anyways, wanted to show you guys a Speed Racer build that I did a few years ago. Three years ago. Now, the one in the background on the display that you see, that's actually one I've already shown you guys in the previous videos of the Speed Racer hauler truck that I scratch built. This one here on the rotisserie spinning table, if you will, that's the same kit. It's a let me double check that and make sure. Yep, Polar Lights kit, just basically snap together. But as you see, I cut the doors, cut open the hood, the trunk. I scratch built an engine for this car, as well as made the inner door structure. Little details here and there. The chassis is still basically stock. I didn't do any undercarriage because it was a full belly pan car. There was no reason to show transmission or drive shaft or exhaust or anything. It supposedly hides away. Anyways, my build or version of this build was I wanted it to look more like the vintage Ferrari. And I put a set of spoke wire wheels on it, two prong knockoffs, and left it without the racing decals. Painted this car Wimbledon white, which is a Ford color. Some of you probably already know that. And I used a single stage paint. Unfortunately, when I sprayed it, it didn't really turn out as slick as I wanted it to be, but I can live with it. Like I said, I'm not perfect. I can handle it. Not really sure if I ever put enough paint on it to be able to wet sand and polish it out, because it being a single stage paint, I didn't put a clear on this one. It comes glossy. And yeah, like I said, 3 years ago and I haven't done it yet. It's not gonna happen. Just understand that it's not gonna happen. But let me get you down here, show you a little more detail about this car. Like I said, I put a set of wire wheels on it, and the details on the wire wheels is they have the valve stem caps. The interior detail is basically stock. I mean, I didn't do anything with it. Built the door panels, and yeah, you can see the orange peel in the paint pretty good. So it is what it is. It'll be all right. But that's the engine. That's completely scratch built. There's nothing in there that's really engine related. But with this particular car, the Mach5, you wouldn't really want to put a small block Chevy in it, you know. So wanted to do something a little more different. Like always, right? I say that a lot, I'm sure. But yeah, I thought you guys would like this one. If we have any Speed Racer fans out there. Now, to show you something else, I talk a lot about building stuff from styrene plastic, sheets of styrene plastic. Well, this is one of the things I've built also that you can do the same. It's just sheets of styrene plastic cut down to size, whatever, to build a display case. Sorry about that. A little display stand to put your model on or whatever. As a matter of fact, this one actually goes on this display. Yeah. So I know it looks like looks more accurate with this one because of the decals, but like I said, I built this 3 years ago and wasn't planning on putting the decals on it. And I've only built this one here maybe about a year ago, or actually probably less than a year ago. So I know it looks better with the actual Mach5 with all the decals on it, but it's my fantasy world. I'll just live in it. Anyways, I just wanted to show you guys that, but maybe that display or one of these cars might inspire you to do something similar. You know, it's better than cardboard. At least you don't have to worry about it falling apart and warping out, as long as you use a right thickness of the styrene plastic. And you can get this stuff in several different thicknesses. If you get on Amazon and look up sheets of styrene plastic, they have several thicknesses, from the thickness of a penny on up, actually even thinner, paper thin. But anyways, you guys have a great Saturday. Enjoy your day, enjoy your weekend. I'm sure a lot of you guys earned it. Be safe. I'll catch you on the next one. Later.